High-end radio, nigga.
On the Sickness Network. High-end radio, you on the air. Who's this?
You already know, Mr. Blotted I himself, man. Hexa Hella Extra Hill. Shout out to Mozzie.
What's up, big homie?
Blotted. Man, what's talking about it, Ollie?
Oh, man, check this out, man. We glad you pulled up on us, man. You know you the busiest cat that we know right now.
Man, you know it's pull-up activities. I had to come function with you, with the fellas, man. Well, I can all the way. You already know. Sickness was talking about it.
Okay, so what you doing right now, man? What you doing today, bro?
Oh, you know, we just maneuvering through this traffic right now. I'm in these Sacramento streets functioning with my bruh, Hus Mozzie. We in this big body thing, packed out. You know, it's all kind of curtains in this motherfucker. We smoking this good dope, sipping this good swine. You know, just regular activities, nothing major.
Yeah, man, as it should be. Man, for those who don't know and been somewhere under a rock, man, go on and tell the people, man, who you are and a little bit about yourself, man.
Man, if you ain't never heard of Mozzie, you should dome yourself, period, man. If you participate in any type of street activities, any type of gang-related activities, if you come from any type of struggle, you know what I'm saying, me, nigga, on my mama, nigga, this nigga, we provide music for you, period, man. So this is what you need to be tuned into right now in 2015, man. Illest niggas to do it, man. Me and my camp, shout out to Filthy Rich, my brother like a motherfucker, the whole Live Wire gang, you know what I'm saying? Me, Nano been holding me down. I ain't got nothing but love for the Yay Area and my Live Wire niggas, but you know, nigga, that's right now. It's Mozzie, man. Everywhere a nigga go, it's Mozzy. That's what they requesting. That's what they want to hear. That's who they want to see. We pulling up in nigga slum villages, bouncing out. You know, we call that vulnerable situations. But it's just to let the people know, nigga, we touchable. We reachable, man. We you, nigga. Nigga ain't made it out the slums. You feel me? So, you know, it's just a Mozzie mean money. Mozzarella, short for Mozzarella. You know what I'm saying? Mean money over Zeri Zane Youngin. And, nigga, we the dopest to do it right now, man. R.I.P. to King Jack.
Well, man, we damn sure want to hear some Mozzie here on High End Radio.
Word up, man. Throw your nick on that motherfucker. What I gotta do, come with a clean version, man, and quit talking about knocking niggas' noodles off and shit.
Hell no. give him the way you know how to give it to him, man.
Give him to him the way you know how, brother. We gonna take it just like that. Now,
straight up, period. Word to mother.
Now, we gonna line you up and get this interview, you know, get this interview going, man. You know, let the, you know, get the people some, you know, inquiring minds, man. So, how old were you when you decided you wanted to be serious about rapping?
Man, I've been rapping since a child, man. Since 1, 2, 3 into the flow. Snoop Doggy Dogg is like the dress at the door. You know what I'm saying? A nigga been doing that shit, you feel me? And, you know, I'm just keeping it lit. I really took this shit serious at like 17, 18, but they wasn't taking me serious, you feel me? It took a minute for the people to take me serious. So, you know, a nigga been doing that shit. That's why I'm, you know, a nigga out rapping. And I'm living a lot of these niggas, man. A lot of these niggas don't even know how to, you know, me chop up the wordplay like that and really present it to the people because these niggas ain't been through it. You feel me? So, you know, I take the delay of game. I take the delay of game, man. You know, I take it on the chin. It took me a minute to get where I'm at. But, you know, it's if it wasn't for that, a nigga wouldn't be able to give it to you. You know what I mean? A nigga wouldn't be able to serve you raw sushi. You feel me?
Okay, what on it? What part of the sack did you grow up in? You feel me? Talking about you from the sack tail for that 916, man. What part of the sack did you grow up in?
Shout out to Sacramento. They know I don't represent this motherfucker. Based on all the gang-related activity in this motherfucker, we damn near funk with A side. Nigga, we the mid. Murder mids, to be exact. Old Park, 4th Avenue. Any nigga they heard of Sacramento, they gonna inquire about Old Park because they know that's one of the hardest hoods out here. There's a lot of niggas out here with the stuffuses. Don't get me wrong, nigga. We don't control the murder rate by ourselves. But at the same time, though, any nigga, if niggas know me, niggas know. If niggas know the key, niggas know, man. We the illest to do this shit, bro. We the most authentic. We just cut from a different fabric. It's a lot of niggas. We not like these niggas, man. We not like them niggas. You feel me? We got a different swag, a different von sway, a different culture. You feel me? We talk different. Nigga walk different. Niggas move different. You feel me? So, you know, I mean, it is what it is. But I'm from Old Park, 4th Avenue.
Okay, 100. 100. Beautiful Struggle was one of your biggest songs. What was the motivation behind that record?
Man, y'all can't do that to Blotted Out. You know Blotted Out was the biggest, baby. These niggas ain't not, but Beautiful Struggle, as a nigga just reflecting on my lifestyle, you feel me? And I know this shit ain't pretty at the end of the day. Man, it can get spunky for a nigga, you feel me? As we speak, it gets ugly out here, you feel me? And a nigga damn near, I mean, the way they presented it, they acting like I'm fully involved. I'm just trying to be a rapper, but Beautiful Struggle is just letting you know that, like, nigga, you gotta embrace it however it come to you. You feel me? You gotta embrace it how it come to you. I got niggas in the pen and they smiling, nigga, with 100 something years hanging over their head, but nigga, they smiling. You feel me? Cause it's a beautiful struggle. You feel me? Whatever they did to get that 100 piece, ain't not worried about it. They took it on the chin, man. And you know, it's a beautiful struggle. They in a predicament where it's ugly, where it's spunky, but they embrace it. So it's beautiful, man. Once you, when you learn to embrace something, nigga, the shit become beautiful. You feel me? That's all that was, man. I was just reaching back. I was just letting people know, giving people a more internal aspect of what's going on in my life.
Right. Yeah. You gotta go through it to get to it. You know what I'm saying?
You know, a nigga got, you know what I'm saying? I'm a regular nigga, real regular nigga at that, man. So, you know, it's like, nigga, I'm just trying to express and let people know, like, nigga, this shit, it ain't all what it's cracked up to be. The shit look fun, it look glamorous, it look like, but it gets spunky, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Niggas is out here, nigga, with children, nigga, growing up without a daddy. You feel me? Growing up without a father figure. It's real out here, so, you know, it's a cycle. Nigga, I grew up without a father figure. And, you know, the lifestyle I live, nigga, it's a possibility. My daughter might grow up without a father figure. You know what I'm saying? Me? So it's a beautiful struggle. It's that's what it is, period.
Exactly. Exactly, man, great way of explaining that to the people. One Mob has one of the dopest projects out right now. Yeah, who came up with the One Mob concept?
Man, I'm just, you know, it's a blessing for me to be a part of that, straight up. And I really can't tell you the whole ins and outs of it. You know, it's a secret society, but at the same time, man, a nigga Filthy Rich snatched me. You know what I'm saying? I mean, and the nigga just told me, nigga, I'm a part of this, you feel me? And it was just like, you know, I'm up out of Sacramento. I'm up out of all another region. If you look on there, man, I'm a 4 Oakland niggas, man, and 1 Sacramento nigga. So, you know, it ain't lopsided. Right. But, you know, to the people, it may look lopsided. They asking why they ain't go snatch another town, nigga. Why they ain't snatch this nigga? Why they snatch this nigga? You feel me? But it wasn't like, nigga, a roll call. It was natural. It just came natural, man. And, you know, them niggas embraced me. I embraced them niggas. I fuck with them niggas tough. Straight up, there ain't no way around it. And so, you know, it is what it is, man. It's One Mob, nigga. I don't give a fuck what nobody talking about it. Nigga, I don't care who against it, nigga, on anything. Nigga, I treat this motherfucker, nigga, like it's my gang, nigga. One Mob, nigga, one umbrella, straight up. One Mafia, La Fiella, huh? Blah, blah, blah.
One of our favorite lines in your songs is, I heard you say a few times, is, solid as a team used to be when we was 10 deep.
So
the fans can get a better understanding. What's the meaning behind that?
Man, you know, that's when you coming out, nigga, when you first jumping off the porch, man, and you know, you know who your niggas is and who you fuck with, and you basically ciphering through your squadron. You know what I'm saying? Me, it's really like a nigga that just jump into the gang life, you feel me? A nigga going to school with these certain individuals, and you know, these niggas is, you know what I'm saying, they rocking. So if I'm hanging with these niggas, it's mandatory that I rock. It ain't optional. And, you know, back when we was rocking, when everything was peachy, when a nigga could shoot somebody in the face and the whole hood wouldn't tell on you, that's when we was 10 deep. That's when it was 10 niggas, you know what I'm saying, me claiming this shit. That's when a nigga knew exactly who was from this shit. That's when a nigga could pinpoint and be like, you not from this shit, because it's only 10 of us. Nigga, it ain't 11 of us. You feel me? Yeah. So, nigga, it was solid back then. It was solid. It was love back then. It was, we was just coming up. We was young. We was fresh, you know what I'm saying? And the circle got took in, you know, you know how they do, man. They say divide and conquer, man. They divided my niggas, man. And they, you know, we got all these goofball ass niggas, these sleazeball ass niggas, these cornball ass, these dorks, these nerds. You feel me, nigga? Portraying that they really functioning with it. When that ain't the case, nigga. The niggas who function with it was when we was 10 deep, nigga. That's when our circle was small. That's when we was jumping niggas in. You feel me? So, you know, that's all that is. It's basically like summing it all down to, nigga, my real niggas is dumb, man. Nigga, I'm to the neck. Nigga, circle smaller than a dot. You understand me? But it was real when we was about 10, 20 deep. That's when the love was real. That's when the gang was tight. That's when we was, it too many nerves, nigga, infested this shit. So, you know, it's something different today.
So I pull up on Mozzie. We hop in the whip. You feel me? We roll up, man. We fire some of that kush, man. Who Mozzie gonna be slapping, man? Who Mozzie got in deck, man? Who
that's crazy. You know I just put that big body suffer. Nigga can't be telling that the whole little class is in the numbers on that thing, cause you know the suckers is working. But you know I got that big body suffer, nigga, with that 5-disc changer. Every CD in that motherfucker got something to do with King Jack, nigga, period. The realest, the biggest shit, nigga, as far as I'm concerned, understand me? That nigga talked about my life. We was doing drive-bys to that nigga music. Understand? We was pulling up on niggas to that nigga music. We was shooting dice to that nigga music. We was selling dope to that nigga music, man. So, you know, it's a nigga, all praise go to nigga King Jack, straight up, man. That's who on my deck right now. All 5 CDs is King Jack.
Okay, man, shout out the boy King Jack, man. We're going to have to get some King Jack on this thing, too. What can we expect from Mozzie coming up?
You know, I got hex of hella extra shit dropping. I mean, I'm going to keep dropping till they drop me. You hear me? It's like I said, it gets spunky out here, man. And, you know, tomorrow ain't a promise. That's the only promise. So my work ethic is crazy. You know what I'm saying? And it's like once you on, nigga, it ain't no telling how long you gonna be on, so you gotta apply pressure. You gotta put your foot on their neck, nigga, and you got to really get it in. So as you can see, I've been getting it in, nigga. I've been out for 7 months. I damn near got like 15 projects up under this Mozzie Records Present. It's about 15 to 20 projects, nigga. I'm talking about a 7 month, nigga. You do the mathematics. That's like a nigga dropping 2 projects plus every month. You hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, we got that one up top coming, one up top, hot, dope as shit. Majority of the beats produced by Joan on the beat. My brother like motherfucker. You know, that nigga E-Mozzie got some crazy shit finna drop Shelly Rue. They finna crack the gate in a couple days. You know, that nigga, he got some dope shit. We just gonna keep feeding y'all this pure dope. We ain't gonna cut it.
That was exactly one of my next questions, though. When can we expect the E-Mozzie album?
Oh, that motherfucker probably be out like... It'll probably be out like no later than February.
Okay, 100. So look, man. Let's have a little fun, man. Before we get up out of here, man. You know, a couple ladies want to know, man. Especially my homegirl Dominique. You feel me? Shout out to homegirl Dominique and shit.
Shout out Moo
and shit. Couple ladies want to know, man. Are you single?
Oohlers. Like a motherfucker, you know, I ain't gonna lie, I got hella bitches. You know, a nigga could damn near just get on Instagram right now and scroll through the DM. The bitch game goes crazy. You know what I'm saying? I get the fuck a bitch in the back of my vehicle, though, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, a nigga gotta put the bitch booty on some of this whatever. You hear me? But, nah, I ain't single. I got hella bitches. You know what I'm saying? Me, straight up, I got hella bitches, and I'm taking in hella, nigga, any type of applications. If you a qualified applicant, nigga, I'm chapping in, and I'm functioning with you, and I'm living life, man. You know what I'm saying? Man, I don't expect the bitch to be faithful or single or none of that, man. A bitch can come fuck with me and have 100 niggas long as she paying. You hear me?
As she should. Okay, celebrity crush.
If you had action at any celebrity bitch right now, Mozzie, who would you hit?
Oozers, already told y'all niggas on the last interview, you know I kept yelling the bitch days off, but I guess my one nigga knocked her off. What's the nigga name? Who knocked my bitch off? The nigga Dirk. Shout out my nigga Dirk, man. The nigga knocked my bitch, man. So, you know, I'm feeling some type of way. You hear me? But I'll probably rock with her. I ain't gonna lie, but I've been selling that old school. You know, I be on my Alicia Keys, heavy.
Yeah, man.
She
just showed up on Empire looking real good, too.
Yeah. You hear me? You know, I punches with the light bite, damn near white. You know, and on top of that, you can see a little strength in her, man, and that's what a nigga need behind him, a lot of strength, man. I need a bitch that's gonna push with me, cause you know we fast forward on this shit, but yeah, I function with Alicia Keys, but you know she act like she don't like short dark skinned niggas, man. I'm coming for daddy's love, homie.
Check this out. Before we get up out of here, homie, you want to give any shout outs? Give everybody your Twitter, your Instagram, your Snapchat, all that good shit.
Man, you already know, man. I want to shout out to the real, man. I shout out to niggas that keep this shit 100. The niggas that look in the mirror, man, you know what I'm saying, me, and they satisfy with self. You feel me? I shout out to the real bitches holding real niggas down, to the niggas sitting down looking at 100+, man. You know what I'm saying, me, with thoughts of never getting out, you know what I'm saying? They contemplating suicide and jumping off tears and all that. I want to get them niggas a shout out. Them the niggas I do it for. Shout out to my squadron, niggas who push with me, you feel me, heavy. Q Hus, you know what I'm saying? Me, that nigga E Mazi, that nigga Nano from Wild Wild, function with me. You already know that nigga Shelly Rookie, both nigga hood, nigga. We putting on fitness, man, for tapping, breathing on the nigga for his interviews and things. Hey, nigga, again, I'll be on the Instagram heavy, Mazi member, MOZZYMEMBA. I don't really function with Twitter or Facebook. And send me DM me, I'll shoot you the line. You could breathe on a nigga, yeah, send me direct. And just keep looking forward to this dope ass shit, man. We ain't really worried about funking with these suckers. We ain't even bringing up suckers. We not tripping off none of that. It's just real pure dope music for niggas to tune into. And we up, nigga. I mean, check the scoreboard, nigga. We up. You know what I'm saying, me? Right now, we running this shit, nigga. If you from California and you ain't got Mozzie on your shit, nigga, you's a motherfucking dork, nigga. You know what I'm saying, me? Straight up, huh? Man, you know, that's when you coming out, nigga, when you first jumping off the porch, man, and you know, you know who your niggas is and who you fuck with, and you basically cyphering through your squadron, you know what I'm saying, me? It's really like a nigga that just jump into the gang life, you feel me? A nigga going to school with these certain individuals, and you know, these niggas is, you know what I'm saying, they rocking. So if I'm hanging with these niggas, it's mandatory that I rock. It ain't optional. And you know, back when we was rocking, when everything was peachy, when a nigga could shoot somebody in the face and the whole hood wouldn't tell on you, that's when we was 10 deep. That's when it was 10 niggas, you know what I'm saying, me claiming this shit. That's when a nigga knew exactly who was from this shit. That's when a nigga could pinpoint and be like, you not from this shit. Because it's only 10 of us, nigga. It ain't 11 of us. You feel me? So, nigga, it was solid back then. It was solid. It was love back then. We was just coming up. We was young. We was fresh, you know what I'm saying? And the circle got took it. You know, you know how they do, man. They say divide and conquer, man. They divided my niggas, man. And they, you know, we got all these goofball ass niggas, these sleazeball ass niggas, these cornball ass, these dorks, these nerds. You feel me, nigga? Portraying that they really functioning with it when that ain't the case, nigga. The niggas who function with it was when we was 10 deep, nigga. That's when our circle was small. That's when we was jumping niggas in. You feel me? So you know that's all that is. It's basically like summing it all down to, nigga, my real niggas is dumb, man. I'm to the neck, nigga, circle smaller than a dot, you know what I'm saying, me? And but it was real when we was about 10, 20 deep. That's when the love was real. That's when the gang was tight. That's when we was, it too many nerves, nigga, infested this shit. So, you know, something different today.
So I pull up on Mozzie. We hop in the whip. You feel me? We roll up, man. We fire some of that kush, man. Who Mozzie gonna be slapping, man? Who Mozzie got in deck, man? Who
that's crazy. You know I just put that big body suffer. Nigga can't be telling that the whole little class is in the numbers on that thing, because you know the suckers is working. But, you know, I got that big body suffer, nigga, with that 5-disc changer. Every CD in that motherfucker got something to do with King Jack, nigga, period. The realest, the biggest shit, nigga, as far as I'm concerned, I'm saying, that nigga talked about my life. We was doing drive-bys to that nigga music. I'm saying, we was pulling up on niggas to that nigga music. We was shooting dice to that nigga music. We was selling dope to that nigga music, man. So, you know, it's a nigga, all praise go to nigga King Jack, straight up, man. That's who in my deck right now. All 5 CDs is King Jack.
Okay, man, shout out the boy King Jack, man. We gonna have to get some King Jack on this thing too. what can we?
I got niggas in the pen and they smiling. Nigga with 100 something years hanging over their head, but nigga, they smiling. You feel me? Because it's a beautiful struggle. You feel me? Whatever they did, nigga, to get that 100 piece, they not worried about it. They took it on the chin, man. And you know, it's a beautiful struggle. They in a predicament where it's ugly, where it's spunky, but they embrace it. So it's beautiful, man. Once you, when you learn to embrace something, nigga, the shit become beautiful. You feel me? So, That's all that was, man. I was just reaching back. I was just letting people know, giving people a more internal aspect of what's going on in my life.
Right. Yeah. So you got to embrace. You saying you got to go through it to get to it. You know what I'm saying?
Go through it to get to it, you know. A nigga got, you know what I'm saying? I'm a regular nigga, real regular nigga at that, man. So, you know, it's like, nigga, I'm just trying to express and let people know, like, nigga, this shit, it ain't all what it's cracked up to be. The shit look fun, it look glamorous, it look like, but it gets spunky, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Niggas is out here, nigga, with children, nigga, growing up without a daddy. You feel me? Growing up without a father figure. It's real out here, so, you know, it's a cycle. Nigga, I grew up without a father figure. And, you know, the lifestyle I live, nigga, it's a possibility my daughter might grow up without a father figure. You know what I'm saying? Me, so it's a beautiful struggle. It's that's what it is, period.
Exactly. Exactly, man. Man, great way of explaining that to the people. One Mob has one of the dopest projects out right now. Yeah, who came up with the One Mob concept?
Man, I'm just, you know, it's a blessing for me to be a part of that straight up. And I really can't tell you the whole ins and outs of it. You know, it's a secret society. But at the same time, man, a nigga filthy rich snatched me. You know what I'm saying, man? And the nigga just told me, nigga, I'm a part of this. You feel me? And it was just like, you know, I'm up out of Sacramento. I'm up out of all another region. If you look on there, man, I'm a four Oakland niggas, man, and one Sacramento nigga. So, you know, it ain't lopsided. Right. But, you know, to the people, it may look lopsided. They asking why they ain't go snatch another town, nigga. Why they ain't snatch this nigga? Why they snatch this nigga? You feel me? But it wasn't like, nigga, a roll call. It was natural. It just came natural, man. And, you know, them niggas embraced me. I embraced them niggas. I fuck with them niggas tough. Straight up, there ain't no way around it. And so, you know, it is what it is, man. It's One Mob, nigga. I don't give a fuck what nobody talking about it. Nigga, I don't care who against it, nigga, on anything. Nigga, I treat this motherfucker, nigga, like it's my gang, nigga. One Mob, nigga, one umbrella, straight up. One Mafia, La Fiella, huh? Blah, blah, blah.
One of our favorite lines in your songs is, I heard you say a few times, is, solid as a team used to be when we was 10 deep. So the fans can get a better understanding. What's the meaning behind that? Interview going, man. You know, let the, you know, get the people some, you know, inquiring minds, man. So, how old were you when you decided you wanted to be serious about rapping?
Man, I've been rapping since a child, man. Since 1, 2, 3 until the 4. Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the door. You know what I'm saying? A nigga been doing this shit. You feel me? And you know, I'm just keeping it lit. I really took this shit serious at like 17, 18, but they weren't taking me serious. You feel me? It took a minute for the people to take me serious. So, you know, a nigga been doing this shit. That's why I'm, you know, a nigga out rapping and out living. A lot of these niggas, man, a lot of these niggas don't even know how to, you understand me, chop up the wordplay like that and really present it to the people because these niggas ain't been through it. You feel me? So, you know, I take the delay of game. I take the delay of game, man. You know, I take it on the chin. It took me a minute to get where I'm at, but you know, it's if it wasn't for that, a nigga wouldn't be able to give it to you. You know what I mean? A nigga wouldn't be able to serve you raw sushi. You feel me?
Okay. What on it? What part of the sack did you grow up in? You feel me? You talking about you from the sack town for that 916, man? What part of the sack did you grow up in?
Shout out to Sacramento. They know I don't represent this motherfucker. Based on all the gang-related activity in this motherfucker, we damn near funk with A side. Nigga, we the mid. Murder mids, to be exact. Old Park, 4th Avenue. Any nigga they heard of Sacramento, they gonna inquire about Old Park because they know that's one of the hardest hoods out here. There's a lot of niggas out here with the stuffuses. Don't get me wrong, nigga. We don't control the murder rate by ourselves. But at the same time, no, any nigga, if niggas know me, niggas know. If niggas know the P, niggas know, man. We the illest to do this shit, bro. We the most authentic. We just cut from a different fabric. It's a lot of niggas. We not like these niggas, man. We not like them niggas. You feel me? We got a different swag, a different von sway, a different culture. You feel me? We talk different. Nigga walk different. Niggas move different. You feel me? So, you know, I mean, it is what it is. But I'm from Old Park, 4th Avenue.
Okay, 100. Beautiful Struggle was one of your biggest songs. What was the motivation behind that record?
Man, y'all can't do that to Blotted Out. You know Blotted Out was the biggest, baby. These niggas ain't not, but Beautiful Struggle, as a nigga just reflecting on my lifestyle, you feel me? And I know this shit ain't pretty at the end of the day. Man, it can get spunky for a nigga, you feel me? As we speak, it gets ugly out here, you feel me? And a nigga damn near, I mean, the way they presented it, they acting like I'm fully involved. I'm just trying to be a rapper, but Beautiful Struggle is just letting you know that, like, nigga, you gotta embrace it however it come to you. You feel me? You gotta embrace it how it come to you.
High End Radio, nigga.
On the Sickness Network. High End Radio, you're on the air. Who's this?
You already know, Mr. Blotted Eye himself, man. Hexa Hella Extra Hill. Shout out to Mozzie.
What's up, big homie?
Blotted. Man, what's talking about it, Ollie?
Oh, man, check this out, man. We glad you pulled up on us, man. You know, you the busiest cat that we know right now.
Man, you know it's pull-up activities. I had to come function with the fellas, man. Well, I can all the way. You already know. Sickness was talking about it.
Okay, so what you doing right now, man? What you doing today, bro?
Oh, you know, we just maneuvering through this traffic right now. I'm in these Sacramento streets functioning with my bruh, Hus Mozzie. We in this big body thing, tacked out. You know, it's all kind of curves in this motherfucker. We smoking this good dope, sipping this good swine. You know, just regular activities, nothing major.
Yeah, man, as it should be. Man, for those who don't know and been somewhere under a rock, man, go on and tell the people, man, who you are and a little bit about yourself, man.
Man, if you ain't never heard of Mozzie, you should dome yourself, period, man. If you participate in any type of street activities, any type of gang-related activities, if you come from any type of struggle, you know what I'm saying, me, nigga, on my mama, nigga, this nigga, we provide music for you, period, man. So this is what you need to be tuned into right now in 2015, man. Illest niggas to do it, man. Me and my camp, shout out to Filthy Rich, my brother like a motherfucker, the whole Live Wire gang, you know what I'm saying? Me, Nano been holding me down. I ain't got nothing but love for the Yay Area and my Live Wire niggas, but you know, nigga, that's right now. It's Mozzie, man. Everywhere a nigga go, it's Mozzy. That's what they requesting. That's what they want to hear. That's who they want to see. We pulling up in nigga slum villages, bouncing out. You know, we call that vulnerable situations. But it's just to let the people know, nigga, we touchable. We reachable, man. We you, nigga. Nigga ain't made it out the slums. You feel me? So, you know, it's just a Mozzie mean money. Mozzarella, short for Mozzarella. You know what I'm saying? Mean money over Zary Zane Youngin. And, nigga, we the dopest to do it right now, man. R.I.P. to King Jack.
Well, man, we damn sure want to hear some Mozzie here on High End Radio.
Word up, man. Throw your nigga on that motherfucker. What I got to do, come with a clean version, man, and quit talking about knocking niggas' noodles off and shit.
Hell no, no. Give him the way you know how to give it to him, man.
Yeah, give him to him the way you know how, brother. We gonna take it just like that. Now,
straight up, period. Word to mother.
Now we gonna line you up and get this interview. You know, get this expect from Mozzie coming up.
You know I got Hexa Hella Extra shit dropping. I'ma keep dropping till they drop me. You hear me? It's like I said, it gets spunky out here, man. And, you know, tomorrow ain't a promise. That's the only promise. So my work ethic is crazy. You know what I'm saying? And it's like once you on, nigga, there ain't no telling how long you gonna be on. So you got to apply pressure. You got to put your foot on their neck, nigga. And you got to really get it in. So as you can see, I've been getting it in. Nigga, I've been out for 7 months. I damn near got like 15 projects up under this Mozzie Records Present. It's about 15, 20 projects, nigga. I'm talking about a 7 month, nigga. You do the mathematics. That's like a nigga dropping 2 projects plus every month. You hear me?
Yeah.
Right. So, you know. So, you know, we got that one up top coming, one up top. I dope as shit. Majority of the beats produced by Joan on the beat. My brother like a fucker. You know, that nigga E. Mozzie got some crazy shit finna drop Shelly Rue. They finna crack the gate front in a couple days. You know, that nigga, he got some dope shit. We just gonna keep feeding y'all this pure dope. We ain't gonna cut it.
That was exactly one of my next questions, though. When can we expect the E. Mozzie album?
Oh, that motherfucker probably be out like... It'll probably be out like no later than February.
Okay, 100. 100. So look, man. Okay, look. Let's have a little fun, man. Before we get up out of here, man. You know, a couple ladies want to know, man. Especially my, you know, especially my homegirl Dominique. You feel me? Shout out to homegirl Dominique and shit.
Shout out Mo.
Shout out Mo and shit. Couple ladies want to know, man. Are you single?
Oohlers, like a motherfucker, you know, I ain't gonna lie, I got hella bitches, you know, a nigga could damn near just get on Instagram right now and scroll through the DM, the bitch game going crazy, you know what I'm saying, me, I get the fuck a bitch in the back of my vehicle though, man, you know what I'm saying, me, you know, a nigga gotta put the bitch booty on some of this, whatever, you hear me, but, nah, I ain't single, I got hella bitches, you know what I'm saying, me, straight up, I got hella bitches, and I'm taking in hella, any type of applications, if you a qualified applicant, nigga, I'm chatting in, and I'm functioning with you, and I'm living life, man, you know what I'm saying, man, I don't expect the bitch to be faithful or single or none of that, man, a bitch can come fuck with me and have 100 niggas long as she paying, you hear me?
As she should. Okay, celebrity crush.
If you had action at any celebrity bitch right now, Mozzie, who would you hit?
Oh, Zars. Already told y'all niggas on the last interview. You know I kept yelling the bitch days off, but I guess my one nigga knocked her off. What's the nigga name? Who knocked my bitch off? The nigga Dirk. Shout out my nigga Dirk, man. The nigga knocked my bitch, man. So, you know, I'm